losing. Computer, increase speed and overtake. Lock phasers on target.
Increasing speed, unable to overtake. Locking phasers on target.
Readings at 93%. Down that ship before it has a chance to jump.
Gaining, but they're moving too fast. Temporal vortex open.
Quinn, you must pursue and engage.
Acknowledged. Computer, maximum warp. Computer, computation update. Have you been able to determine our position and time plane?
Whereabouts unknown, not connected to host.
Estimate?
Tallow Ceti star system. Approximate star date 4523.2.
How much lead time does Jalon have?
Based on inherent data only, approximately 47 hours.
Computer, scan memory bank for pertinent events current to the star date, plus or minus 200 hours.
Data returned one significant event. On star date 4527.1, Federation Starship USS Constitution, Arise Planet Gyral in System L361. Constitution carries emergency medical team to halt pandemic from annihilating the planet's inhabitants.
Bulkist! Computer. Set course for Planet Gyral. Maximum warp. Time to planet?
32 hours, 57 minutes.
Channel all information regarding the Gyral rescue.
Captain's log, star date 4725.5. Now departing medical starbase ME-16 en route to Planet Gyral at maximum warp. Our mission is unclear, but we are meeting with Starbase SMO Farrell for a full briefing.
All right, Doctor. You and whatever's in my cargo bay are on board. What is the big secret?
You're familiar with the planet Gyral?
Gyral is inhabited by a pre-industrial race with no perception of other worlds or cultures. A couple of hundred years before the Federation would even consider it a candidate for first contact. I believe it was the initial scouting mission that deemed it a hands-off world, as per Article 1 of the Prime Directive.
That's correct, Mr. Foster. But the planet is in the throes of a pandemic, one that has already annihilated a third of the planet's population. The Constitution is transporting a vaccine that will curb the outbreak.
What is it? What do they have?
It closely resembles COVID-29 that was rampant on Earth in the late 21st century. But the Ganali lack any real medical technology. Left unchecked, the virus will decimate the population.
Then it's your intention to use the vaccine to inoculate the Ganali population.
Correct. We'll use satellite dispersion to saturate the planet's atmosphere. Once airborne, the vaccine will take immediate effect, reversing the virus.
Will, you seem pretty confident in efficacy of this vaccine, Doctor. How can you be so sure that it will work? All right, give it to us, Doctor. We're on the same team.
We were able to experiment on some of the victims.
Experiment?
Yes.
Experiment how?
We've been monitoring the planet much more closely than the Federation would have you realize. One of our medical teams inadvertently released a virus on a flyby mission.
So, we caused this?
Yes. But we mean to fix this.
How can you be so sure this vaccine will work?
We were able to access several cadavers from the Ganali. The vaccine is a hybrid of our formula mixed with native antibodies.
Cadavers? You would have needed a live host to experiment on.
Yes. That's true. It has taken some time, but we have perfected the vaccine, and the effects will be immediate. It's our responsibility to save these people.
Your actions, Doctor. I can't imagine a clearer example of violating the Prime Directive.
The mission is fully Federation sanctioned.
Oh, why don't we just build an embassy down there while we're at it?
Wait, Federation protocol is quite clear regarding non-interference.
Non-interference, Mr. Booth, when the situation is confined to internal circumstances. These circumstances, we are most definitely external.
But the ramifications of violating the
Prime Directive.
We
are most violating.
Well, enough! Everything.
What's morally right or wrong? And what do we have to do to fix it? I'm sure you won't mind, Doctor, if I confirm these orders directly with Starfleet.
Go ahead. They are fully aware.
Everyone get back to your duty stations. I'll confirm these directly with the Federation, and we'll reconvene at 1900 hours. Dismiss.
Computer, distance to Constitution.
95,000 kilometers.
Activate cloak. Computer, distance to Constitution.
40,000 kilometers.
Shields?
Not initiated. Shields are down.
Long range sensors. Find a suitable beam and location near Cargo Bay 4.
Location established. Coordinates being fed into transport controller.
Computer, if I do not return to the ship within 4 hours, initiate auto return transport sequence.
Acknowledged.
Wish me luck. Thanks.
Alert.
What is it?
Temporal sensors have detected a shift in the time corridor. Event path now skewed.
Calculate effects on future events?
Negligible. Probability indicates no appreciable shift at this time.
Time to intercept?
1 hour, 57 minutes.
Time to hailing distance?
23 minutes, 41 seconds.
Notify me when we are within hailing distance.
Acknowledged.
Excuse me, sir. This is an authorization zone.
Here on orders from the SMO. See for yourself.
I'll have to talk to the captain. Sweeney to Bridge.
Bridge here. Go ahead, Sweeney. Sweeney? Sweeney, respond. Sweeney, respond, please.
Captain's log supplemental. Now 7 hours from planet Gyral. We've lost contact with our guard in the cargo bay. Security is being sent to investigate.
Stop what you're doing!
Stay away from the vaccine!
Who is he?
He's dressed as an ME-16 medical member, but I believe it's a disguise, sir.
Well, whoever he is, he clearly has a mission.
No. What happened, Doctor?
Sabotage the serum. The vaccine is inert. No chance of recovery.
Captain's log supplemental. Sensors have detected an unidentified small craft approaching the Constitution. We are attempting to establish communication.
Readings on the ship, Mr. Foster.
Well, the signature appears to be Federation, but the configuration doesn't seem to match any design that we're aware of. Plus, the sensors are unable to penetrate their hull.
Captain, we're losing potency in our antimatter chamber. We can barely register it, but it coincides with the arrival of that ship.
Keep monitoring, Lieutenant. Lexia, weapon status?
It's hard to be sure, sir, but the ship has a full weapons complement that's not initiated. I also did a scan of the engines, and Captain, I think that ship is equipped with transwarp drive.
Ramirez, open a channel.
Channel open.
This is Captain John Chandler of the USS...
Yes, Captain. I know who you are, and I'm aware of your current mission. Requesting permission to beam aboard. I have some urgent information regarding your guest.
Well, would you mind at least introducing yourself first?
Sure. Protocol first. Quinn.
Quinn. That's it.
It is. If you allow me to beam over, I can give you some more details.
Very well. Stand by while we prepare to beam you over. Chandler out. Booth?
Captain, I have the coordinates locked on. We're ready.
Energize.
Captain Chandler.
Do you know me, sir?
Not exactly, but your reputation precedes you. I have some urgent news that I request to speak to you privately. No offense to your first officer, but I need to speak to you alone.
All right, Mr. Quinn, what's with all the secrecy?
I don't mean to mistrust your officers, but I have some urgent news that needs to be held to the strictest of confidence.
Well, anything you say in this room will stay here.
I'm from the future, Captain. The 28th century, to be exact.
It was always my understanding that temporal agents don't normally make themselves known.
Only in times of extreme duress, and this is one of those times. I was in pursuit of the saboteur, who I believe is aboard the Constitution. His ship jumped ahead of mine.
Yeah, the cloaked vessel we picked up.
Yes, no doubt. You and I need to go and interrogate him to find out who he is and why he's returned to this place in time, before he does any damage to the timeline.
We may have already had an impact. I believe our visitor sabotaged the vaccine and left our entire supply on the ship inert.
What? That event is not part of the log timeline. The damage could be considerable. You need to take me to the saboteur. As odd as it may sound, we may have very little time.
I need Booth.
The danger of changing the timeline.
The timeline's already changed. You explained that yourself. I need Booth. I trust him. And so can you.
All right, Captain. But we need to go now.
Well, there's no time like the present.
Like I haven't heard that before.
Am I still on the Constitution?
Yes.
And the vaccine?
Inert. Useless. Why did you do it? Why did you come here?
We ask again.
Why are you here?
My name is Jalan, from the planet Junili.
That's planet 5 of this system.
I came back to stop the Constitution from saving. After you released the antidote, the surviving Ganali became warlike, while my planet remained peaceful and non-violent. 300 years from now, Gyro will become technologically advanced, developing high-energy weapons and space travel. 400 years from now, Gyro travels to Geneva and conquers us.
And what happens to your people?
Dead or enslaved.
And you?
Born a slave, then found the Federation.
But you wouldn't help us. Your prime directive wouldn't let you. So I stole one of your time shuttles.
So your plan was?
Wipe out the inhabitants of Gyro. To avoid years of torture and domination of my people.
Looking for this?
I have a responsibility to prove the severity of my situation and the lengths I will go to make you understand. I live in the future. If I die in this time, it's immaterial. But I will not allow my people a fate they do not deserve. To that end, there is nothing greater that I can offer to prove my sincerity. Except my life.
How do we fight that?
We can't. But we're obliged and under orders to save the Ganali.
But the future. I admit, I wasn't expecting this when I was following Jalon. And I'm sympathetic to his situation. I truly am. But changing the historical timeline of any era or location is forbidden by the Temporal Prime Directive. Those are my orders.
So what do we do?
I'm not quite sure, Captain. History records that somehow the Ganali survived. And if that's true, I need to return to my ship. Computer, cancel visualization. Scan all events involving the planets Gyral and Junili, starting this stardate, involving any incidents to this current mission. The first timeline is the elimination of the vaccine. Elaborate on other events.
Without the antidote, 92% of the Ganali perish from the pandemic. The remaining 8% rebuild the planet, become a superpower over the next 300 years, and become aware that Junili plotted to eradicate their planet. On stardate 2787, the Ganali launch an attack on Junili and conquer them.
Computer, what is the closest starbase in the sector?
Starbase 751.
start a course for Starbase 751. Temporal Agent 75324.1.
Attention Ganali Fleet, this is Admiral Richard Stone of the Federation Starship T'Pol. May we inquire as to your reason for being here?
Greetings, Admiral. We are here on a mission of exploration.
As are we, Captain. However, your armory will have us believe that you are on a different mission. I strongly suggest you power down your weapons and return to your home planet.
We are not accustomed to taking orders.
I suggest a new custom. I repeat, power down your weapons and return to your home planet. End transmission.
Aye, sir.
Looks like they got the message. The Ganali fleet is in retreat.
Thank you for your help, Admiral.
Yours too, Commander. We'll remain in orbit until the first contact team is safely embedded. So, where are you off to now?
Home.
So how'd it go?
We were successful.